I'll empty out your tank and then I'll go empty one of these trucks, I think.
I figured you just call, you know, leave the cart to fold in. Or you can dump the cart too and just write down the deem weight.
I emptied the whole cart out. Yeah, but we're already at 100 and like 10,000 liters of beans, so.
We're doing good, boss. Now we just need Mike on. Oh, yeah, I hit control two. I set a different GPS line.
Yeah, I figure if we can do 600,000 in beans and another 600 in barley, we'll be sitting pretty good.
Yeah, but how much does a new kitty cost us?
I think I'm gonna trade in the two T9 fours.
You really think the T8 would pull that other 2720, or are you getting rid of those two?
Well, I'm gonna keep we're gonna have to get rid of one of the T9s, and we're gonna.
I'd say get rid of the E9 track because the wheeled one seems to pull some of the things better than the tracks do.
And then we could use that to pull like the DN or something, or.
Yeah. Because you don't. I mean, a 450 track like that is kind of overrated. I'd just keep the duals. You might get better price for the track, too. The track in the 2720s or 2623. What happened to our cultivators? Did those go away, too?
I sold the cultivators because we're gonna pick up a disc.
Yeah, but the disc doesn't give you the cultivator texture. Are you not gonna cultivate it after that?
Yeah, the disc is a cultivator. It's not a plow.
No. Perfect. 2720 or 2623 should make quick work of the field.
Yeah.
Well, Joe posted it. AFP.
I mean, I think we'll have quite a bit of money to play with, 'cause we have 365 days to pay off our loan. If I look at my loan details, we have 2.2 million left. No, 1.8 million left to pay off.
Yeah,
And
but isn't that going to go up when we renew fields?
it's gonna cost us money to renew our leases, but it costs us like I fixed that finance mod too, so because we were getting like too much in subsidy, so I dropped it down to like 2%. So we're gonna lose probably like 2,000, 2,500 a day, maybe 3,000 on our interest and our loan and our land lease, but
It'll be more realistic.
the land is leased at 250 an acre.
Yeah, so was the subsidies cash back or what?
Like we get every dollar we sell, we get taxed at 6%, but then we get land subsidies, so all the land that we own, we get 2% back. So it's
It works out.
it works out to. Field 18 We got a lot of beans left, thank God. 15.
Field 18, field 44 is gonna be a lot.
Even 15 is gonna be quite a bit. 15, 18, 44. We got a lot of barley too.
Yeah.
Man, if we ever get a great demand at Budweiser, we're gonna be set.
Yeah. We're gonna need to buy another bin set up here pretty soon.
I think we might actually have enough bins if we use our
small ones.
The
Is that
small
where you
ones.
Put the beans at?
No, I'm putting the bean ones in the big one. The only thing, it doesn't show up, it doesn't have a display.
Oh. I probably would have taken the wheat one out and made a bean display.
I'm gonna have to eventually.
Cause are we really gonna do wheat? Or are we just gonna stick with barley?
I just went with barley as like a big one-time thing to kind of like take advantage of the Budweiser.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I remember like 2 months ago when we were playing all the time that
it was always kind of stuff.
It was like every week we were getting a barley great demand at Budweiser. So
yeah.
I mean, maybe eventually we can like start doing sugar beets or something.
That would be fun again.
Cause I mean, we can only like bring in so many soybean and corn.
But the question is, what? What are you gonna use to lift your old lifter, the self-propelled one?
Probably do a self-propelled, so we don't have to defoliate.
That yellow one or whatever. I heard that caused a few people here to patch errors after 1.4.
What?
That yellow one that I sent you a video of.
Oh, I have it. I have it, so it works well with drive control and stuff.
I think it was patch 1.4. Screw stuff up like patch 1. What was it? Screwed up. Wind chaser. Was it 1.3 or what?
1.2.
Yeah.
I mean, we could either do that, or we can maybe start getting into a little bit of a logging. You know, once all of our crops and soil management's done, we can start doing some logging or something. I don't know. Or we just go do the same thing and maybe do like wheat and barley for Budweiser.
Switch it every year. 1 year wheat. Well, if we get take care of great demand, it'd be like plant a little bit of wheat here, plant a little bit of barley here.
Yep.
I just went ham on photos on Facebook right now, so I couldn't help myself.
And then we have field 20. Maybe we should convert 20 to something else and do another field as alfalfa or something. I don't know. Definitely need to farm more acres. 23, 19, 29. Be a good start. We have this small rusty bin complex right here that we could buy too if we ever need extra space, so.
Yeah. Well, if we ever make our way up north, could get the big bin site there by the house.
Yeah. I mean, that big bin complex there by the bee farm, you could buy that, but it costs just so much. And,
yeah.
You know, 8, 9, 16, 36, all those fields could probably fit inside this rusty one, you know?
Probably. The rusty one is great. I remember using that one. Oops.
It's actually more, it's actually bigger than.
Yeah. But
than
it's
the one
to,
by our farm, so.
It's got close proximity to a lot of fields, and if we ever do pick up 9, 16, and 8 again. Yeah,
I think we will.
Figured do as long a rows as we can, and this was the longest way to do them. Probably the same way we'll do 15. I'll get a reset, hopefully it stays.
we really knocked out that corn. We should have planted more corn, really.
Yeah. But if you want to get 600,000 of wheat and barley, you kind of got to put a lot of ground to corn.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like,
so if we do, at least 29, 23, and if we wanted at least 19, at least that's quite a few. Can you imagine 19 as corn?
I think we should do 19 as corn.
Be like old school. Two combines and a cart and a truck going across the field. That was an epic pick. I think I still have that pick for a throwback Thursday. The yellow combine, the red combine,
yep.
The cart, and the truck driving across the field. All on the same GPS line. See, if only you or Mike could dump your combine into my hopper and we're going across the field. I'm getting full. Help me.
So what do you think? Do you think we should transition into to Kitty or keep New Holland combines? Or, I mean, we don't have enough money to do anything, really.
I mean, I'd go Kitty or an RT for a four-wheel or for a big tractor.
I mean, they're both really good. I just like the windows on the Challenger better than the Deer.
I'm perfectly fine with the Challenger. I mean, the yellow's gonna look pretty great with that blue cart.
Yeah.
And then the yellow looks pretty great with the green disc, as you can see in my photos. I mean, we're gonna need a bigger tractor, something that can pull it.
Yeah, easier. I think it's between the RT and the MT right now.
I'd go MT. Unless you take,
I just don't really like the articulator, you know? Articulated,
yeah.
Tractors, so.
Unless you're gonna go edit the windows in the RT, but I like the Challenger. I mean, then if later on down the road we ever get into those 770 Lexions, then we're already kind of still in the same,
yeah,
company.
Maybe one day I'll finish the Rogue Gator too, so. Could have small Kitty to do like side dressing or a land roller or a planting tractor.
Small Kitty'd be great for the 24 row and the roller.
Yep.
Yeah. The small Kitty'd even be great on the DN.
Yep. I think we'll go the Challenger route.
I think so too. Might as well. We got the best Challengers in the game.
I should make the new hood for the 800 too. All I have to do is add two more lights to the 700 model. And
well, no, they're changing that hood again for the new series.
Really?
For the new year, they changed that hood again. My buddy told me they aren't going with the 700 hood. They're going with a different one. And I can't even get pictures of it.
You mean the one that Julian already made? They're changing that again?
Yeah.
They only went with it for a year.
Not even.
So,
buddy said there's a new hood out at the one in, the one tractor in Jackson, but you can't take a photo of it.
Oh, what the hell? Can you describe it?
He says, I don't know how to describe it, but it looks badass. I go, that doesn't help me.
He can sneak a photo for me, can he?
Yeah, I'm sure he could. I should ask him the next time he goes to Jackson to haul a 800 series.
When's that going to be?
I don't know.
I like to,
whenever it warms up.
So do you think that's going to be on the Rogue Gators then?
I think so.
I can see all the way. I can see the sheep in the milk placed in town.
That little pick video I did, that turned out pretty well with that music.
Sandstorm?
Yeah. Like, it slowly goes in as you see the farm, and then it starts to pick up as all three, or both combines come in. I did one with POD, We Youth of the Nation. That turned out pretty well.
Well, Well, the nice thing is, if we ever need money, we got about 400,000 line of credit to mess around with, so. So we're only at 22,000 right now. So we could basically take out a operating loan to get us by till we can sell our crops, you know?
Yeah, so if you trade off the two 2720s and the ATI'd
I'm not gonna sell off the 2720s because we need chisel plows.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So if you sell that, you should just go in and see what it costs you to sell there, because what is it, 20% more at the store if you bring it there?
I mean, the new disc is 109,000.
Yeah, but I'm talking that 450 ATI to a cat. What's that gonna cost us? Probably 130, 150 difference. I wouldn't sell a sprayer. Having two sprayers is nice.
If we were to sell, we'd get 150, 155,000 for the ATI.
Yeah, but you get more, you get so many percent more if you drive it up there and sell.
Yeah, we get like 20% more.
So you get like 160 probably. What's a new kitty cost?
We'd probably get
350?
like 175, 180 for it. And a new kitty is 359,000.
So we're roughly looking at
We'd have to
probably.
come up with like another like 180,000.
So we need almost 300,000 to get tractor and disc.
If we were to get a disc, we would need about 280, 300,000, yeah.
So we need a great demand.
That would be, I mean, if we were to sell all of our corn, we would pay for that and we'd have 70,000 left over, really.
Yeah, plus we wait for great demand.
But then we have all of our beans and barley. You know, that's probably like, I don't know, that's probably like close to 1 million. I think if we did everything great demand, we'd probably be over 1 million in revenue.
Perfect. It's up to you how quick you want a kitty.
Well, we definitely need a DN. The thing is, like, we can get away with renting, but I mean, how often do you wanna?
I mean, I could understand renting the DN. I understand that, but
Yeah.
renting a kitty, you might as well just buy the kitty for the cart. We're gonna need it for the cart.
Well, that kitty's gonna be going the whole. It's gonna be on the 2720. It's gonna be on the 2623. It's gonna be on the. It's gonna go all year round.
Yeah, so I mean, there's no point in renting the kitty. It's up to you if you want to rent the disc for tillage season for a couple seasons. Maybe just rent it for a season
Yeah.
till we get a big, great demand. I mean, that's what I would do, because then it's going to be cheaper for us to get the kitty right now, and then we could just rent the disc for
Like a day
when
or
we need it.
two. We
Yeah.
could do all the tillage with that thing in like a day.
Can you imagine if we had two of those and two kitties when we get really big?
I'd rather just rent like a two DNs before we trade anything in, broadcast all of our nutrients, then bring the DNs back, trade off one of the tractors, and get a kitty and a disc. And then have one of the T9s doing chisel plow and kitty doing, you know, and then figure it out. But definitely like rent two DNs right away and just
Go ham.
put down the line, put down NPK, and then till everything in and see where we're at, you know.
Yeah, I'd go for that. It sounds like a good plan.
'Cause we don't really need the kitty till we hit tillage. And we can't do tillage till we do like our
Well,
fall application
you
of.
don't really need it, but it'd be helpful on that cart.
Yeah. I definitely think after we sell a lot of our crops, we're gonna. I mean, the thing is, do we keep our 12-row headers? Do we get a pair of 16s? Do we?
I just keep the 12. I mean, the 12 on corn, like if you get to 19, a 12 is going to be sufficient for Mike trying to keep up or somebody in the cart trying to keep up.
I purchased that Draper for like $112,000, so we own that Draper.
It's nice to own a Draper. If you want to run a second one, it's just easier to rent.
Yeah, and you can just drive the truck down and pick it up. You don't need a combine, so.
Yeah, because it comes with the trailer. But yeah, you'll probably want to grab me when we come back to the other side.
You could probably fit the rest of that field in your bin, can't you?
Yeah. You lazy.
Lazy? Hey, come on. I learned from the best.
Yeah. Oh, don't you dare back up and take a picture. Oh, I'm backing up to take a picture.
Bringing the truck back to the farm.
Oh. What, bring one of them back to the farm? Oh, you're taking a pickup. Yeah. I don't know why the truck's moving. There's a lot of hard beans. I mean, beans go quick with a pretty head.
Yeah, those fields aren't. They get pretty small with a 45 foot Draper.
We should make it. It'll be really close.
I do like these fields, though, with the river running in between them.
Yeah.
Especially that corn with the chopped straw and the tracks through it. Looks like it's from 13.
Wait,
once again.
Wait till we get to 19. I bet we get 20. I bet we get 20 trucks off 19, at least.
Yeah, we got 13 off of 17.
Yeah, 19 looks bigger.
We would come close. We'd probably be around 18, 19 trucks.
They definitely fill the bins, huh?
I mean, if we're pulling a I can fit your whole tank in the cart, so that's nice.
Yeah.
Was that like 40, 46,000 off of?
Yep.
12?
Yep.
Not bad.
No.
Off of this little field. What is that, like 1,300 bushel?
Yeah, probably.
So you're looking at $13,000 to $26,000 off this field?
Not bad, but how much should we put into it?
Not that much, I don't think.
Seed-wise?
Probably put in...
Be nice to, well, go through course playing single player to see actually like how much it's going to cost you per seed.
Yep. I like that because it tells you how much it is per seed, the size of the field. It helps you manage quite a bit. Getting things done.
Yeah. Imagine if we had two of these. If we saved 15,
I think I did somewhere. It's either saved as 12 or 15.
I think it's saved as 15.
Either way, just line it up to the dirt road and you should be good.
Go back to sleep.